Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team. Today, we are going to be taking a look at how we can document our service treatments when in our part. We are beginning with this copy machine, and for this video, we are going to specifically explore how we can create PMI for the coding layers applied to the lid. After this, we will also look at how coding layers can be displayed in our part drawings. To get started, the first thing I'm going to do is open up the second window where I've already loaded our lid. When I open the coding navigator, we can see that three different coding layers have already been applied. To produce PMI for these layers, we can use a pre-created rule from the logic editor. To view this, I'm going to open up the MBD navigator where we can see a rule called PMI Note. To activate this rule, I'm going to right-click and select Update. When this is completed, we can see that the PMI notes attached to each coding layer are now displayed on the screen. If we click on any of the notes, the region the code is applied on will be highlighted within the part. This is a great way to distinguish where each note is intended and helps in organization of more complex parts and assemblies. The next thing we are going to look at is how we can further explore any existing rules. If we right-click and select Edit on the PMI Note rule, we get a new window that opens containing the steps that were taken in Logic Editor to create the rule. Here, any necessary changes can be made to address new design needs, or we can just use these steps to better understand the rule's capabilities. For our purposes, we can just leave this rule as is. The last thing I want to explore is how we can take a part drawing and tie in any necessary surface treatment information. As you can see, for this part, the base view and two projective views have already been placed on the drawing. To add our coding information, we can select Parts List, and the material and quantity of each coding layer can easily be included. This is yet another way to ensure that necessary coding information is translated from the design process to manufacturers. In conclusion, in this video, we reviewed two ways to document our surface treatments. The first way we looked at was the implementation of PMI notes through a previously created logic editor rule. We then reviewed the makeup of this rule and how any changes could be made. The other form of documentation that we explored was the use of a parts list on our part drawing. This quickly provided the necessary materials and respective quantities needed for each coding layer to be produced. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.